So now we are going to discuss another procedure for the calculation of the bolt torque for the flanges. Now, as per Dennis Moss, 4th edition. So bolt torque required for sealing of flanges. Let's have a look at first this force triangle. How this force triangle will look like. So first try and understand this direction. Indicates us the absolute force value. So the absolute force value has been indicated in the vertical axis, and on a horizontal axis we can see that, let's say this is a neutral position before application of any bolt load or before application of a tightening torque and before application of any pressure. So before that, let's say the bolt is having a length x. So during pressurization and during torquing of that particular flange, the bolts are going to be get elongated. So this direction represents the elongation of bolt. So whenever we are going to apply the torque or whenever there will be pressure inside the flange joint, that pressure will try to push the flanges away and that will put the bolts in tension. So that elongation of bolt is represented from this towards right side. Whereas whenever we are going to apply the bolt torque, the gasket is going to get compressed. So the compression of the gasket, as the elongation is in left to right position, so the compression would be from right to left position. So we can see from this point the compression of gasket will start, right? So this is the point from where the elongation or tension in the bolt will start, and this is the point from where the compression in the gasket will start. So let's just revise the thing again. So this direction indicates us the absolute value of the force. From this point, the bolt will be going to the tension, or we can say the elongation of the bolt will be represented by this direction. At the same time, whenever we are going to apply the torque, the gasket is going to get compressed. So that compression is represented from this point towards this. So the compression is from right to left and elongation is from left to right. How the compression value is going to get changed because of the relaxation of the gasket, that is also we are going to discuss. So let's say you can see that whenever we are going to apply the pressure, the bolt will go under elongation and the gasket will be under compression. So we can say at this particular point, the bolt has been elongated and this will be the value of the force, absolute value of the force, correct? And this shows us the elongation direction. So this is how the elongation will happen. This is how the elongation will happen. And this will be the force value, total force value, what we are going to get. And this is nothing but the compression, how the compression of the gasket will happen once the pressure will be in place, or we can say whenever we are going to apply the bolt torque. So at this particular position, this point represents the total bolt load. This point represents the total bolt load. And this force value or absolute value of this force represents the joint contact surface compression load. That is HP, which is 2 pi BGMP. So this HP is nothing but joint contact surface compression load, which will be given by the value or the equation what has been given in Appendix 2 of ASME section at Division 1 is 2 pi BGMP. And from this point to this point, whatever absolute value of the force is there, that magnitude is represented by the force H, which is called as total hydrostatic end force, which will be calculated as pi by 4 g square p. So this represents joint contact surface compression load, and this represents the total hydrostatic end force H. And this total together, if we sum up these two, that represent WM1, which is nothing but the bolt load in operating condition, which also can be referred to W. So we can say W in operating condition will be the summation of HP plus H, or H plus HP, whereas HP is joint contact surface compression load and H is total hydrostatic end force. Now, after some time, the gasket is going to fill the irregularities on the flange surfaces, and because of that, the gasket will be going to get further compressed, and there will be relaxation in the bolt is going to happen, because right now, let's say the gasket is compressed and the gap between the flanges is 5 mm. The gasket was earlier 6 mm, now it has been exaggeratedly, let's say, compressed to the value of 5 mm. Now this 5 mm, what will happen, this 5 mm after some time will there is some irregularities on the flange surfaces, as we have seen that more detail in relaxation part of ASME PCC. You can refer to that section as well. So there what will happen, this gasket will feel the irregularities on the flange surfaces, and the gap between the flanges will further reduce, and because of that, whatever elongation has happened into the bolt, that is further going to get reduced because of this relaxation of gasket. The elongation is going to get again reduced. So because of the gasket relaxation, from here onwards the gasket will keep on relaxing. So you can see that the formula for WM1, which is nothing but the total bolt load in operating condition, is H plus HP. H is nothing but what? Hydrostatic end force. Total hydrostatic end force that will be calculated as pi by 4 G square B. Pi by 4 is nothing but 0.785. And HP, total joint contact surface compression load, that is represented as 2 pi BGMP. 2 pi BGMP. Here 2B represents the total width of the gasket. B represents only the effective width of the gasket, and 2B represents the total width of the gasket. So here the total width of the gasket has been considered in the calculation. So this is how the equation 1 represents the total value of the WM1, which we also called as a bolt load W, which is an addition of H plus HP. So this is about the initial pressurization, but after some time the gasket is going to feel the irregularities on the flange surface, and because of which it is further going to get compressed, or the gap between the flanges is further going to get reduced, because of which the elongation of the bolt is going to come down. It will be going to come down. So we can see from here the gasket is going to get relaxed, and because of that this elongation also have been dropped down, and this is the new value of the final elongation of the bolt, and this is the absolute value of the total final force during operation whenever pressure will be going to get applied. So once the pressure will be going to get applied, after some time the gasket is going to get relaxed, and because of the relaxation of the gasket, the tension or elongation of the bolt will be reduced, and this will be the new value of the total final force. Earlier it was WM1, or we can say W, which was equal to H plus HP, but now this value of H has been reduced, and this is the new value. And this will be the new value which will be represented by delta F. So earlier it was H, now it has been reduced to delta F, and the total force, earlier it was W, which was H plus HP, and now the total force during operation is now come down as FBO. So FBO is total bolt load at the operating condition, which is nothing but HP plus delta F, and earlier it was total bolt load in operating condition, it was H plus HP. So we can observe from here, because of the relaxation of the gasket, H has been reduced to delta F, and W has been changed to FBO. So this is the understanding of this force triangle. And now if we just have a look at, so let's say this is the initial position of the bolt, and it was elongated first till this value, and it is again the elongation has been reduced, and this is the final value of the elongation. So what will happen? This is nothing but the total change in length of that bolt, or we can say the total tension in that bolt, or this is the original length, say, let's say from this point to this point was 100, and it has been come to 100 and let's say 10 exaggeratedly, and then again come back to 108. So now this 108 minus 100, that represents 8 mm, which is nothing but the elongation of the bolt. So this value or the magnitude represents the elongation of the bolt, and from here to here the gasket is totally get compressed. So this represents the delta TG as a value of the compression of gasket. So the this represents the total reduction in the thickness of the gasket, or we can say compression of gasket, and this suggests us the elongation in the bolt length. So this is elongation of the bolt length in magnitude wise, and this is compression of the gasket, and this is delta TG. So this is the interpretation of this total force triangle. Similarly, There will be a force triangle for W also, which will be gasket based upon the gasket sitting load. This is for total operational load, what we have seen. And this delta F represents change in the joint load due to the gasket relaxation. As the gasket is going to get relaxed, because of which there will be a reduction in the force that will be observed. As we have seen in case of ASME PCC1 also, how this relaxation will work, we have seen in much detail. So you can refer to that section for better understanding. Now, let us have a look at calculation procedure for finding out the bolt torque. So first, we are starting with step one. So in the step one, we are going to calculate the equivalent pressure PE, which is going to be get applied onto the flange assembly. So this is the same formula, P is equal to 4F upon pi j square plus 16M upon pi j cube plus P, whereas P is nothing but the actual design pressure. And this moment and force is nothing but if there is some external force or the moment coming onto the flange, which is going to open up the flange, that force we have to consider. And this is nothing but the Kellogg's equation by which we can convert that force in the form of pressure. And this is the equation by which, or this is the term by which we can convert the moment in the form of pressure. So what we are doing, if at all there are any external forces or moment coming onto the flange which are trying to open up the flange, because of that there will be some pressure developed. So that force and moment we are converting in pressure and we are adding up into the design pressure. But let's say if there is an axial force which is going to compress the flange and not open up the flange, so in that case we don't have to consider this term. This term will be zero. But the moment, if is there any kind of moment apart from torsional moment is going to twist the flange, not open up the flange. So apart from torsional moment, if there is a MC or ML value that we should be considering during this equation to convert that moment in the form of pressure, and that pressure we have to add into the design pressure, and that will represents the total effective pressure. And if there are no external forces and moment, these terms will be zero and only your design pressure will be acting as your effective pressure. So in this equation particularly, what is F? F is actually pulling force. That is what I have just explained. The force has to be pulling in nature. That is supposed to open up the flange. As like by the pressure, also the flange is going to get open up. The pressure is going to push the flanges away from each other. If your pulling force is there, which is also resulting in the, giving us the result in the same direction, then only we should add its effect. So that's the reason why it has been written as actually externally pulling force, not pushing. If this force is in pushing the flanges together, so what will happen? Because of that, the gasket will be get more compressed. The flanges will not open but close. So in that case, this force will not be considered. Only if it is pulling in nature, then only we have to consider. Now moment caused by any external loading apart from the torsional moment, it should not be the torsional moment. It is not going to open up the flange. Then G is nothing but the diameter at the location of the gasket reaction as per the mandatory appendix 2 in inches, right? G is nothing but the diameter at the location of the gasket load reaction. That also we have seen in detail how to calculate the value of G. Then P represents the design pressure in PSI. All the units are in feet pound system. So here, or we can say customary units. So P is equal to design pressure in PSI. All the units what have been mentioned in Dennis Moss are in customary units. So this is about the calculation of the effective pressure. Then we are going to move towards step number two. In step number two, what we are going to do? Calculation of the hydrostatic end force H. Calculation of hydrostatic end force H. We have seen the formula pi by 4 g square P. So here H is nothing but hydrostatic end force calculated as pi by 4 g square P, where H is hydrostatic end force. The answer will be in pound because the pressure will be in PSI, pound per square inch. Then area will be in inch square. So inch square is going to get cancelled and your force will be coming in pound. So G represents the diameter at the location of the gasket load reaction as per the mandatory appendix 2. The value will be in inches. PE is nothing but the effective pressure, which is a combination of the pressure caused by axial force. If it is in pulling in nature, then moment and the design pressure. If there is no force and moment, then it will be equal to your design pressure. And its unit, what we need to consider in our calculation, will be PSI. Now we are going to move towards step number 3, calculation of the total joint contact surface compression load, which was represented as HP in that force triangle. Also, we have seen HP is nothing but the force caused by the total joint contact surface compression load, that is because of the gasket compression. It was represented from right to left. It was moved from right to left because it was a compression. So HP is 2 pi BGMP. HP, the value is 2 pi BGMP, whereas 2B is nothing but the width, pi into G, or pi D we can say is representing the diameter, 2B represents the total width. So this represents the area multiplied by the pressure. So that will give us the force. So 2 pi BGMP, and M is nothing but the M factor of the gasket, which is called as a maintenance factor. For more details, refer to our flange lecture. Now, HP is total joint contact surface compression load. It will be in pounds. G is diameter at the location of the gasket reaction as per the mandatory appendix 2 in inches. PE is effective equivalent pressure in PSI. And M is the gasket factor. And B is nothing but the effective gasket width. And that width will be in inches. So that represents what? HP, total joint contact surface compression load. Now in step 4, what we are going to calculate? Calculation of the bolt load for gasket setting condition. We are calculating bolt load as per appendix 2 for two conditions. One is the operating condition, another is gasket setting condition. Just now we have seen the procedure for the calculation of the bolt load for operating condition, which was H plus HP, and for gasket setting condition it is represented as WM2, and WM2 is equal to what? Pi BGY. Pi BGY represents the bolt load calculated for gasket setting condition, where in this case WM2 is nothing but required bolt load for gasket setting condition. Gasket setting means at operating temperature, or let's say ambient condition, when we are going to apply initial torque, the gasket should be set properly so that during operation it will not leak. So that is called as a gasket setting condition bolt load. So this load will be required to set the gasket properly. So WM2 is required bolt load at gasket setting condition in pound. G represents the diameter at the location of the gasket load reaction as per mandatory appendix 2 in inches. Then Y represents the gasket setting stress in PSI. Y represents gasket setting stress in PSI. This value we will be having for different gaskets. Let's say for a spiral wound gasket, it is 69 MPa. For non-asbestos compressed fiber gasket, it is 11 MPa. For PTFE gasket, it is 11 to 20 MPa. So based upon gasket, its seating stress is going to get changed, and that value we have to take. B is the effective gasket width in inches. So this is how we have just seen how to calculate the gasket seating load. Now in step number 5, we are going to calculate the actual gasket area, AG. How we are going to calculate the actual gasket area? It is 2 pi BG. Rather, it is 2B is nothing but the width, and pi G is nothing but the circumference. Circumference, or G, is the mean diameter. So mean circumference multiplied by its width will represent the total actual gasket area. You can either calculate it as pi by 4 into effective gasket width OD square minus effective gasket ID square. So where in this reaction, in this equation, AG is actual gasket area in inches square. G is the diameter at the location of the gasket in inches. B represents the effective gasket width in inch. B represents the effective gasket width in inch. You have seen that formula as 2B. Why 2B has been used? If we just have a look at, B represents only the half of the total gasket width. So the total gasket width will be 2 times of B. Here you can see it has been represented over here only because the gasket face, or we can say the flange face, is till this point. If the flange face would have been at this point of location, then it must be from this point till the center. So this is effective gasket width from one side. So we are taking the total gasket width, which is 2 times of B. Then this is nothing but the 2B what we have just seen, that is total effective width of the gasket. And this is nothing but the mean diameter, or we can say the gasket load reaction diameter G. So pi G will represent this circumference, multiplied by 2B will give us the total cross section area of this gasket. So now we are going to move towards step number 6, in which we are going to see the calculation of decreasing compression force in the gasket. We have seen H, now that H will be reduced to delta F. We have seen in the force triangle, because of the gasket relaxation, and the value of the force H, that is hydrostatic end force, will be reduced to delta F. Now this delta F, if we have a look at the equation, it is H divided by some factor, right? So H divided by 1 plus this term. This term always being positive. So 1 plus anything will be more than 1. And as more than 1 factor is in denominator, you will always see delta F value as lesser than H. We will always see the value of delta F as less than H, because we are going to divide it by a factor which will be more than 1 always. So please try and understand. This represents what? The decreasing compression force, the effect of decreasing compression force because of the relaxation of gasket. So H will be reduced from H will be reduced to delta F by this equation. Let's try and understand what are the various terms or the variables used in this equation. So delta F is a decreasing compression force in the gasket. The value will be in pound. H, hydrostatic end force in pound, we have calculated pi by 4 G square P. Then LB is representing the length of the bolt. Whether we should consider the length of the bolt from flange face to flange face? No, it is from nut center to nut center. So from one side, you have to consider till the nut center. From another side, it should be towards the nut center. So effective length of the bolt from mid nut to mid nut location. So from mid nut to mid nut location in inches, that is your LB. Now TG represents the thickness of the gasket in inches. TG represents what? The thickness of the gasket in inches. Whatever thickness, 3 mm, 4 mm, 4.5 mm, we are going to use the same thickness we have to use in this calculation. Then AB is nothing but the actual cross-sectional area of the bolt. AG represents the actual gasket area. EB represents the modulus of elasticity of the bolting material in PSI during operation, so it will be at the design temperature. EG, modulus of elasticity of the gasket material in PSI. So the value of EB, we know that we can take it from the code ASME section at division 1 in, ASME section at division 1, the reference has been given for Young's modulus, and this thing we have to go to section 2 part D, from where you can get this value, right? But from where we should get the value of the Young's modulus for gasket material. So for gasket material, the value reference is directly given in Dennis Moss. So in Dennis Moss, you can look at this image over here. It is directly taken from there. So modulus of elasticity of the gasket material, they have specified for the various gaskets. So here, based upon your requirement, you can choose the value of the Young's modulus. The value has been given in KSI. You have to convert in PSI, and then you have to use. So KSI multiplied by 1000 will give you the value in PSI. So this is for rubber gasket, graphoil, teflon, spiral wound, then compressed asbestos. So based upon your requirement, you can choose this value. And if this value is not available, then this Young's modulus value for that particular gasket, we have to take from the gasket manufacturer only. If it is belongs to any of these categories, you can choose it from here. If not, you have to take the value of the Young's modulus of the gasket material from your gasket manufacturer or its catalog. So this is about the calculation of the delta F, which is nothing but the reduction of the hydrostatic end force because of the gasket relaxation. Now, since the value of the H has been changed, so the overall W, which was earlier calculated as H plus HP, since now H has been changed. So now the new initial required tightening force FBO will be calculated as HP plus new change force delta F. HP plus delta F. So your initial operating bolt load, which was H plus HP, now it has changed from that to HP plus delta F. So H has been replaced by delta F. Because of the relaxation of the gasket, the value of the H has been reduced to delta F. So this is the new bolt load in operating condition, we can say, during the operation after relaxation of the gasket. So the value has been reduced. Whereas FBO represents the initial tightening force in pounds, HP total joint contact surface compression load, delta F represents the decreasing compression force in the gasket, the value will be in pound. Now calculation of the load tightening force to seal the joint. Now, whatever W, two W's we have calculated, one was for gasket sitting condition, another was for a reduction in the gasket compression. Because of that, we have calculated just FBO. Earlier in appendix 2, we are calculating WM1 and WM2, and we are taking the maximum of it. Here, WM1 has been reduced to FBO. Now that has been replaced by FBO. So the final boat load will be the maximum value of the FBO, what we have just calculated, and WM2, which is pi BGY, which is based upon the sitting stress of the gasket. That is boat load required for the sitting of the gasket. Whereas W is total tightening force to seal the joint in pound, FBO is the initial tightening force, and WM2 required boat load for the gasket sitting condition. FBO is during the operation, how much boat load will be required after relaxation of the gasket, and WM2 is required boat load for gasket sitting condition. So that represents the total value of the W, what we are going to get from this equation. Now we are going to calculate the final value of the torque. If we have a look at this formula, KWDM upon 12N, it ideally equal to the value or the formula what we have seen in PCC1. Only there we have used the stress, so that's the reason why we have multiplied by the area. And here we have considered directly the force. So K is nothing but the nut factor, friction factor, W is the boat load, what we have just considered, which was the maximum of FBO, and WM2 DM is nothing but the diameter of the bolt, N represents the number of bolts, and 12 is nothing but the factor to convert the torque value from LB inch to feet pound. That is pound inches to pound feet or feet pound. So 12 is to convert inches into feet. That's the formula what we are going to use, where W is the total tightening force to seal the joint, K is the total friction factor for the bolt, nut, and flanges. The values are also given in Dennis Moss. For lubricated nuts, you can have in between 0.075 to 0.15, and non-lubricated 0.15 to 0.25. Usually, we are considering it as a value in the range of 0.2. 0.2 is the nut factor, friction factor we are considering. DM is the pitch diameter of the threads. In case of PCC1, it was the bolt root diameter or the nominal diameter of the bolt, rather we can say. And here it is the pitch diameter of the threads. From where this value to be taken? It is also to be taken from Dennis Moss table 3-8, bolting dimensions. Here you can see DM value for that particular size has been mentioned. So DM represents the pitch diameter of the threads. So this is the procedure by which we are going to calculate the actual value of the bolt torque, and N represents the number of the bolts what we have used in the calculation. So let's have the problem. Let's have an example, right? So let's have the following example, and we will try to calculate the actual value of the bolt torque. Let's say the internal pressure is same, which is 15 bar. Now let's convert that in PSIG or PSI, because here we are going to calculate everything in customary units, as Dennis Moss has given only in customary units. So internal pressure is 15 bar gauge, which is equal to 217.5 PSIG. Gasket ID 1705, gasket OD 1737, bolt size UNC 1.25 inches, then M factor 3.75, let's say. y factor 52.4 MPa, which is 5798 psi. Thickness of the gasket is 4 mm. Then external force coming on to the flange. We have not considered any external force, or in this case there is no external force or moment, so that value is 0. Then external moment coming on to the flange M, we are not considering any moment external coming on to this, so that value is also 0. Now number of bolts for this particular problem, the same problem we have been continuing from PCC1 till this point. So number of bolts were 64. Length of the bolt from mid nut to mid nut, let's say it is 400 mm. Then modulus of elasticity of the bolt material, EB, is 204.092 MPa. And the modulus of elasticity of the gasket, EG, is 482.758 MPa. And the value is in PSI, 70,000 PSI. 70 KSI is what it has been mentioned in Dennis Moss. So it is 70,000 PSI, which is 482.758 MPa. So this is the input which will be required for the calculation of the bolt torque. Friction factor K is equal to 0.2. So these are the input. This is the flange geometry again. Let's have look at one more time. ID of the flange 1575, OD 1892, PCD 1828, small end of thickness 15, large end of thickness 25, hub length 30, number of bolts 64, size of the bolt UNC 1.25, gasket ID 1704, gasket OD 1737, face ID 1575, face OD 1737, and the flange thickness is 150 mm. This is our geometry of the flange which we are going to use. So let's calculate the basic variables which will be required for the calculation of the bolt torque. So width of the gasket is 16 mm, B0 is N by 2, which is 8 mm. So B is the effective gasket width or joint contact surface heating width, which is equal to B is equal to CB square root of B0 if B0 is greater than 6 mm. In our case, B0 is 8 mm, which is definitely more than 6 mm. So that's the reason why CB square root of B0 is the formula what we are going to use. If it is less than 6 mm, then B is equal to B0. But in this case, it is more than 6 mm. So it is CB square root of B0. If we are using metric units, CB will be 2.5. Square root of 8, it is come down to be 7.071 mm. And if we convert it in inches, it is 0.2783 inches. Now, G is the diameter at the gasket load reaction. G is defined in the table 2-5.2. If B0 is more than 6, then G is the outside diameter of the gasket minus 2 times of gasket width. Effective gasket width. So it is 1892 minus 2.707. So it is 1722. It is not 1892. It is 1737. It is 1737. So it is 1737 minus. It is 1737 minus the value 2 into 7.07. The answer is correct here. Please consider the value of 1737 minus 2 in 2 into 7.071, which is 1722.858. G is 1722.858 mm. Now we are going to move towards step number 1, calculation of the equivalent pressure. There is no external force, there is no external moment. So this value will be 0. So P will be equal to P. Let's put the values in. FB is what? External force is 0. Moment is 0. Pressure. G, the value of G, which we have calculated in millimeters, 1722.858, which will be 67.829 inches, which we will be using in this equation. Then pressure is in PSI, 15 bar. Let's convert into PSI, 217.5 PSI. So here, let's put the values in. Axial force is 0, moment is 0. These two terms will be getting cancelled. Only the design pressure 217.5, which will be final equivalent pressure. So final equivalent pressure will be equal to 217.5. Now let's move towards step number 2. Calculation of the hydrostatic end force H. Calculation for the hydrostatic end force H. So H is equal to pi by 4 G square into PE. G we have already calculated. Let's put the value 67.829 square into effective pressure, which is 217.5. So we will get the value of total hydrostatic end force H. 78592 4.1 pounds. This is the value of the hydrostatic end force H. Now we are going to calculate the value of HP, total joint contact surface compression load. So total joint contact surface compression load, which is equal to 2 pi BGMP. Let's put the values in. B is effective width 0.2783, G is 67.829, M is a factor 3.75, and P is nothing but the effective pressure 217.5. So HP, that is total joint contact surface compression load, HP, the value will be coming down to be 96,769.26 pounds. So HP we have calculated as 96,769.26 pounds. Now we are going to calculate the WM2 value, which is calculation of the boat load for a gasket sitting condition. So WM2 is pi BGY. Let's put the values. B is 0.2783, G is 67.829, Y is 7598 in PSI. The value is in PSI. So let's say WM2 value has come down to be 450,729.7 pounds. 450,729.7 pounds. Now let's calculate the actual gasket area, which is AG, which is equal to 2 pi into BG. Let's put the values in. 0.2789 is B, G is 67.829, and 118.64 inches square is the actual gasket area. Calculation of the decreasing compression force in the gasket delta F. So the value of H is going to get reduced to value as delta F. So the formula is delta F is equal to H divided by 1 plus ABEBTG upon AG EG into LB. AB represents the actual bolt area, EB represents the Young's modulus of the bolt, TG the gasket thickness, AG actual gasket area, Young's modulus of the gasket, LB represents the length of the bolt from mid nut to mid nut. So let's put the values. Prior to that, let's say delta F is what? Decreasing compressing force in the gasket. H we have already calculated, which is 785,924.1 pounds. Then LB, that is 400 mm, let's convert it into inches divided by 25.4 will give us 15.748 inches. Then the value of thickness of the gasket, let's say it is 4 mm, which is 0.1574 inches. AB, which is pi by 4 d square n, which is nothing but the actual bolt area. So it has come down to be into number of bolts. So total actual bolt area is 60.4458 inches square. Whereas D is the diameter what we have chosen for 1/1/4 inch, the root diameter, which is given as 1.0966 in table 3-8 of Dennis Moss. So from Dennis Moss, we have chosen for 1/1/4 inch, what is the value of D, which is 1.0966. So same value we have used in this, and this is the final actual bolt area, which is 60.4458 inch square. So the AG is having a value, what we have just calculated previously, is 118.64 inch square. EB, which is the Young's modulus of the bolt material, its value is 295.95540 PSI. And the value of the Young's modulus for the gasket is 70,000 PSI. All right, so these are the various variables and these are their values. So let's, this is 70 KSI what we have considered for this particular case. For different type of gaskets, EG value must be taken from the gasket supplier. If there is different value, we must take it from the gasket supplier. Now calculation of the decreasing compression load in delta F, we have already calculated. So let's put the values in. So H we have calculated 785,924.1, 1 plus AB 60.4458 into 295.95540. Thickness is 4 mm, which is 0.1574 inches. AG 118.64 inches square, 70,000 PSI is the value of EG, and LB was 400 millimeters, which is 15.748 inches. So this value 70, this value of 785,000 now will be reduced to this value, which is from 7 lakh, it has come down to 2,49,195.2 pounds. The value of delta F will be in pounds. Now we are going to calculate the initial required tightening force for the operating condition FBO, which is equal to HP plus delta F. And this value of HP is 96,769.26 plus 249,195.2. The value will become down to be 345,964.4 pounds. So MBO value we have calculated, right? Now WM2 also we have calculated pi VGY. Now let's have the final tightening force value, which is the maximum of MBO and WM2. So maximum of FBO, which is 345,964 and 450,729.7. So we can say the gasket setting condition is governing in this case rather than FBO. So what will be happening? So this is the final value, 450,729.7, which was governed by the gasket setting load as the final value of W. And to calculate the torque, let's have the formula in. Torque is equal to KWDM upon 12 into number of bolts, where W is what? 450,729.7 pounds. W is what? 450,729.7 pounds. The boat load what we have calculated, which was governed by the gasket setting load. K is the nut factor, let's say 0.2. This is taken from here. Then DM is the pitch circle diameter for that particular bolt. We have selected 1/14 inch bolt, right? And DM value is how much for 1/14 inch bolt? This is the value, 1.1688. So 1.1688 inches we have taken from table 3-8 of bolting dimension from Dennis Moss. N is number of bolts, the value is 64. Let's put the values in for the calculation of the bolt torque. So K is the nut factor 0.2, W is 450,729.7, DM is the pitch diameter 1.1688, 12 into number of bolts 64. So the total torque value has comes to be 137.19085 feet pound. This 12 is to convert the inches into pound. Everything was in inches, right? This was in pound, this was in inches. So the answer was in pound inches. What we want? Feet pound. So that's the reason why that 12 is in denominator. So inches to feet conversion, we have to divide it by number 12. So 137.19085 feet pound is the value what we have calculated for the bolt torque. This value is as less as 10 times than what we have calculated for ASME PCC calculation. So you can see this value over here, 317.190. Here it is 316.395 feet pound. What we can identify it in, given in where? This is given in PV Elite. Now in PV Elite, unlikely, they have mentioned that they are doing it as per Dennis Moss. FBO and WM2 is the only two things what we need to compare, but they are also taking into the consideration the boat load W and WM1 here. Actually, WM1 is nothing but H plus HP. H itself has reduced and come to delta F, and from where we have calculated FBO. So if we are going to compare that with a WM1 will always be higher than FBO, isn't it? So we can see over here, this is 350,000. This will be always be higher. This is what we have reduced because of the effect of the gasket relaxation. So this is not correct. We should consider, if we are having Dennis Moss as a procedure, we should consider FBO and WM2 only. But since they are considering WM1 or W also, this is more conservative. So you will get more higher value than what we have seen over here. This will be giving more higher value than what we have seen over here in this particular case. So I would like that to mention that PV Elite does it for the values which include FBO, WM2, W and WM1. And that's the reason why it is more conservative. Dennis Moss have only WM2 and FBO values because WM1 has been reduced to FBO. These values are extra PV Elite taking, and that is even more conservative. 0.186 kilonewton meter is what we have gotten in the answer. So let's have a look at the Excel sheet or manual problem, we can say. So this is bolt torque calculation for the flanges. You can see here the pressure is given in MPa, the value. Let's say the pressure was 1.5 MPa. If I want, I can convert into, let's say, bar. I want the pressure in bar, so it will be, I have to mention it as 15 bar. So let's say I have considered it in MPa. So 1.5 MPa is our pressure, thickness 150 mm, G0 15, G1 is 25, D, that is root diameter of the bolt taken from Dennis Moss, 27.85364, which is 1.1 inches. Then pitch diameter also taken from Dennis Moss. Then number of bolts is equal to 64 M. That is the external moment we haven't considered any zero. OD of the gasket 1737, ID 1705, M factor 3.7475. Then a Y factor 52.4 MPa, which has converted in the PSI, e.g. Young's modulus of the Young's modulus of the gasket 482.7586, which is 70,000 PSI. Length of the bolt 400 mm, 15.75 inches. Thickness of the gasket 4 mm, 0.16 inches. It is not 0.16 inches. If we just have a look at it, is 0.1575 inches only. B0 effective gasket width 8 mm. Basic gasket width 8 mm. Effective gasket width 7.0711 and gasket load reaction diameter 1722.8579. This is what we have used. And friction factor is 0.2. There is no external force we have considered. And Young's modulus for the bolt material is this 295.93340 PSI. Now here we have calculated equivalent pressure, which is 217.5 PSI only, because this term is zero, this term is zero. H is 5 by 4, G square P, which is 785,924, HP 2 pi BG, MP we have calculated, WM 2 pi BG, Y we have calculated, AG actual gasket area 118.65 inches square, delta F, H upon 1 plus AB EB TG upon AG EB LB. That value of 785,000 has reduced to 249,195. And FBO, that is the final bolt load during operation, will be addition of delta F and H. It will be H plus delta, HP plus delta F. And HP plus delta F is 345,960. For WM2 value was 450,000. So this 450,000 has been used in this formula of KWDM upon 12 times of number of bolts. The answer has been 137.919 in feet pound, and the final answer has come down to be 0.186 kilonewton meter. So this is how we have calculated the same. We can have any kind of units, and similarly the values will change. Only thing is that you have to put the units correctly over here. So you can have any value. You can see if it is in PSI, 1.5 is equal to 1.5. So we have considered that is in MPa. So this is how we have done the calculations for the bolt torque. Now let us calculate the value of the bolt torque as per Dennis Moss procedure. The provision is also there in PV lead that we can calculate the bolt torque as per PCC1, also as per Dennis Moss procedure also. So what we need to do is we have to go into the flange dialog box, into which we have to go into torque, loads, pass, partition, gasket information. You have seen in the last slides that how we have given these values of ASME PCC1. Now we are not concentrating upon this, rather our interest now in the perform bolt torque calculations as per Dennis Moss. So what information extra we have to give it over here? What is the friction factor, which is 0.2? Here also we have given that. And then main gasket ambient elastic modulus, that is modulus of elasticity of the gasket, which is 482.758, which is 70,000 PSI, which we have taken from Dennis Moss. So that value you have to mention. If there is any pass partition plate and if it is having different elastic modulus, then you have to give it over here, or if it is having same, then you have to put that value over here. Now the bolt effective length from mid nut to mid nut is 400 mm. So this is the additional information we have to give, and we have to click on this checkbox so that the software will also perform the bolt torque calculation as per Dennis Moss. So once we have done this, and if we run this, so we will get the report, into which we will go into the flange design. So in flange design, you can see here The required bolt load torque as per Dennis Moss and ASME PCC 1. So till this point, as per Dennis Moss calculation is there, and here and after that will perform the calculation as per PCC 1. So as we have done actual in the manual calculation, we have calculated actual gasket area. Then we have calculated the value of the delta F, then H plus HP, or rather H plus delta F, HP plus delta F, what we have calculated as the value of FBU, the same what they have done. Then total force in WF, what we have calculated, maximum of FBU and WM2, as we have already mentioned, that PV lead in addition to FBU and WM2 considers W and WM1 values also for the comparison and takes the maximum value from this. So in our case, we have considered only FBU and WM2 because we have just followed the Dennis Moss procedure. Here they are doing it more conservative, because please try and understand, FBO has calculated from WM1 only, H plus HP, and H we have reduced to delta F, and that's how FBO is calculated. If at all we have to take this value, then we never have to calculate this value. Why we have reduced this value? Because of the reduction in this value caused because of the gasket relaxation. So that effect they have considered. If we have taken WM1, then that effect has not been considered. So I would recommend, if you just have to follow Dennis Moss, then you have to take these two. But since it is conservative in nature, you can proceed with this also. So this is what the value of the bolt torque that you will be getting. This is what the value of the bolt torque that you will be getting. You can see here, the value, again, the same mistake has been done. This value is in Newton, what has been represented over here, and this value of the bolt diameter in millimeter, and this value of 12 shall also only be used if it is in inches, right? This is in inches. Then this will convert that into the feet. So here, as they have used this formula, these values must be in customary units. So WF will must be in pounds and DM must be in inches. So if you just solve this equation, you will never get this answer. But what they have done here, they have done the here they have rightly calculated is at the back end and put that value over here. But if you just look at the substitution, that is not correct. That is absolutely wrong, because in this formula where 12 is in division, that is given only for the customary units, and these values should be in WF, should be in pounds, and DM must be in inches. Then only you can divide it by 12 to get it in feet pound. So if you solve this equation, you will not get this answer. This answer is correct, but here the substitution what they have shown is not correct. So this is how the bolt torque we need to calculate. So let's try and understand what is the difference between Dennis Moss and what is the difference between the ASME PCC1 calculation. In Dennis Moss, we are calculating the values which are just required for that bolt load, and that bolt load we are using for the calculation of the bolt torque. One was the operating condition bolt load, which was WM1 H plus HP, and we have reduced the value of H2 delta F to take care of the gasket relaxation factor. So that's the reason why that WM1 has reduced to FBO, which was equal to HP plus delta F. And another thing was, just for the gasket sitting condition, we are calculating the required bolt load, which is pi BGY WM2. And we are comparing these two, and we have taken the value of W in the final bolt torque calculation. So here we are calculating for that pressure, how much bolt load is applied, and for the minimum gasket sitting, how much bolt load is required. And we are comparing these two and taking the higher value. This is what has been done in Dennis Moss. But now, how PCC is different from this? In PCC, what we are doing in Dennis Moss, we are doing just what is required that we have calculated, and that much only torque we are giving. But in PCC1, we are calculating the capacity of the entire flange joint to sustain the stress, and that stress we are using in the calculation. So we can say, let's say here in bolt torque calculation, let's say Dennis Moss says that, let's say 1000 pound inches is what is required for the pressure and minimum gasket sitting. But there we are calculating how much the flange assembly can sustain. So instead of 1000, that can sustain for 20,000. So there we are applying 20,000, so that the chances of the leakages will be much, much, much lesser as compared to what will happen if we apply just the bolt torque which we will be calculating from Dennis Moss. So Dennis Moss will be calculating it just what is sufficient for the pressure and just for a gasket setting. Here no consideration has been given for the maximum boot load, then gasket targeting, then flange rotation. So that all thing we have considered over there, and we have seen that how much the total bolt torque it can sustain. Only that much torque we are calculating, and the same we are giving. So instead of just based upon the pressure and gasket setting, what is required if we are giving, instead of that, how much load the total entire flange assembly can sustain, or how much torque the total entire flange assembly can sustain, that much torque we must be applying. So that if we apply that torque, if your flange, bolt, gasket is safe in that torque, then that will be giving you more chances of not to have a leakage in flange joint. Many a times it has been observed that if we apply the bolt torque just based upon the Dennis Moss procedure, there will be a lot of leakages has been observed in the flange joint, because the value of the torque is very, very less. So it is rather recommended if you are calculating as per ASME PCC1. So you should apply that bolt torque, and that bolt torque, if we compare right now also, so it is almost 10 times than what we have calculated for the Dennis Moss procedure. Because the flange is having that much strength, the gasket is having that much strength, the bolt is having that much strength to sustain that much higher bolt stress, or we can say that much higher bolt torque. So that entire capacity of that flange assembly has been utilized in bolt torque calculation in ASME PCC1, rather than in case of Dennis Moss, it is just what was required for pressure, what is required for minimum gasket setting, only that much bolt torque we are applying. So it is much better to go for ASME PCC1 bolt torque values for the final tightening of the bolts for the flange assembly. That will give you more leak tight joints, rather than just going with the Dennis Moss procedure. So this is about the bolt torque calculation as per Dennis Moss and as per ASME PCC 1 Appendix O.